Hi everyone, welcome back to Creatively Crafted Life. This is Melanie, and yes, I've been busy crafting. Unfortunately, I wasn't able to record any of the processes that I employed this weekend to make these projects because it was part of an event, so I didn't feel right doing that. But I think it should be okay to share with you my finished projects. I participated in an online virtual event called Ready, Set, Create, put on by Down to Details. She is a local person to California, and the event was supposed to be here in Burbank. And unfortunately, with all that's going on in the world, the event moved to a virtual event instead. And so I did still participate, but I participated from the comfort of my home. And what you see in front of you is the Craftermath. So I did complete all the projects, with the exception of one. And I will talk about that here shortly. So the event was a combination of home decor pieces, scrapbooking, as well as card making. So it was a little bit of something for everyone. What was good about working from home is it gave me the flexibility and access to other materials so that I could modify these projects and make them my own. And I've learned that I'm not really good at following directions, meaning I changed almost everything. So the first project that we had was a home decor piece. It was from Clear Scraps, and it was using these pallets that they sell, and it did come with a wagon, and the idea was that you would incorporate the wagon into the pallet, but the wagon just didn't really fit my vibe, so I pulled that out and came up with this instead, and I think this will be a nice little piece to display. Probably more autumnal, although I do have orange in my dining room, so maybe it will have a permanent home there. This was a lot of fun. So this was by Clear Scraps. So the second project was from Pebbles, Jen Hadfield, and it was basically kind of like a traveler's notebook with inserts. I have so many notebooks and covers that I didn't feel that this would be a good project for me to complete, although it was super, super cute. But I did want to show you what kind of supplies we got for this kit. And basically, I've just decided that these would be better suited for me to use to make layouts. So that's why I opted not to complete this particular project. The kits were more than generous. We ended up with a lot of extra supplies at the end of it all, which was kind of fun. And sorry, my desk is a disaster. So we have the Jen Hadfield Ephemera from Chasing Adventures, and then Jen Hadfield Ephemera from Chasing Adventures, the two different packs. We received the journal thickers in black. Of course, there was stuff to help you make the cover and notebook. Plus, we also got a good sampling of cardstock. I wouldn't be surprised if this was the entire collection, so I thought I would just share it with you in case you haven't seen it. It does have a travel theme. What's really great about it is very inclusive, so even though there are people along the bottom, you can see that they have all different skin tones, which is awesome. Okay, so this is Adventure Strips. And the back side are these round medallions with different icons that you could color in. These would easily make embellishments, and of course, these make great borders. On the Go Girls, and then a black and white diagonal stripe. Cherry Blossoms, that's pretty. And then a purple gray floral on the back side. This is called Wildflowers, and then there is a geometric tone-on-tone, kind of pinky purple. Then there is this one with a whole bunch of taxi cabs called Big City, and then a map. And yes, my hands are covered in paint and everything else. Take off, we got two sheets of this with the airplanes on the one side and then words on the other. So a text. This one was really cool. I kind of thought this was a fun take on a travel piece of paper. It's called Tiny Travels. And again, these would be really great cut out and used as embellishments. and then a green grid. And there's Flower Market with a blue floral. We have a cut apart called Enjoy the Journey with an intermixed swirl. Then there is Fiesta Flowers, and then a geometric. And then Wanderlust with these cacti, and then a green on green dot. So that was everything in the kit. Like I said, nothing wrong with the project itself. I just think it better suits me to have these four layouts. Okay, the next class was from Simple Stories using the Kate and Ash collection. And I used their cut sheet to cut the paper down and then started with their layouts and then kind of did my own thing. So there are nods to the original design, but they really don't look a whole lot like them when it's all said and done. So these would become base pages really, although they're a little bit more planned out than my typical base pages. I did add spots for photos and I made note of the mat size. So for instance, this mat is 3 5/8 by 4 7/8 so that I know what size to print the photo at. So this one was really fun. I loved using all the stickers and thickers and stuff to complete this. This was a 2-page spread and it reads like this. And then there was one more 2-page spread. Goes like that. They have a very uplifting kind of message, if you will. So we'll have to find the right photos to go with those. We also received a little make and take to make this little gnome card. This is kind of the sheet that you can purchase. We only had a sampling of this to make the kit. But it's really, really cute. It's, I don't know if you know, but gnomes are all the rage. At least they were starting last year. I believe they do sell dies that will trim these out. I believe. I have not looked into it yet. These are from Colorplay, and this is called Norbert's Birthday Party. Okay, the next morning we were working on a project from Lael Concor, and she has a business called Lael by Mail where she puts together different kits for you to purchase so that you can put them, you know, make your own little mini albums, if you will. This is the album that we put together. I didn't know that Simple Stories had come out with these little albums. They're like report covers, you know, when you were in school with, we used to call them duotangs. I don't know if that's a brand name or whatever. And they are about 6x8. The page protectors are different than the standard page protectors you would put in a 6x8 album. So if you are ordering online and stuff, just be aware that these are floating around out there. Ironically, it's a friend's album and I just finished making one. But this is probably going to be more for photos. And you know what? You always have more stuff from friends that you want to include. So I'm just going to do a really quick flip through. She gave us my mind's eye gingham garden, I believe. I love this collection. It is so pretty and I've used it on other layouts. Very pleased to have a little album made out of this. So this was fun to put together. It did take a little bit longer than I had thought it would. Flap up. Super cute. So now I just need to find photos to fill this. This will probably be an ongoing journal. Then we had another home decor piece by Paula Cheney representing, I believe, Tim Holtz because we used all of his products. See, let me do this without getting any glare on it. I have not been into the home decor thing, so this was really fun to experiment with. Lots of different techniques. I think she incorporated 7 different techniques into this, so it was a great learning experience. And I clearly have to practice some of these because I didn't do so well, but it worked out okay. And the last class was using Graphic 45 paper. I believe it was Fairy Wings was the name of it. We got enough to make 10 cards. I made 17. So we had a lot of product, and I prefer cards to be a little bit more simple. And so that's why I was able to get more cards out of this. Plus, they also provided us with scraps and stuff. So we did get more items to make more cards if we so desired. So let's talk about Graphic 45. They have beautiful paper. It's absolutely gorgeous to look at. It's all kind of collage-y and whimsical, and it's just beautiful. But I usually don't know what to do with it. It doesn't look like it's usually a paper that's easy to cut down, and so I actually don't purchase a lot of Graphic 45 as a result. I think it's beautiful, I just don't know what to do with it. So this class was really good. It really helped me try to think of different ways to use some of their stuff. Now, to be fair, a lot of the cardstock on here is the more simple cardstock, but we did have one of their collage pieces that we cut apart, and I'll show you when I get to that. We also had cut apart sheet, and we had the chipboard. So I'm just gonna flip through these really quickly, so you can see what I came up with. A lot of these, I did not add any sentiments to them. Some of them have phrases in the cut aparts. So for instance, this one here has a phrase that says, "Find the magic that makes your soul soar." But I also figured that when and if I want to send these out, if I feel it's appropriate to add a sentiment, I can always do that at that point. In case you're wondering, I tuck the envelope inside and then store these in a bin so that when I'm ready to mail these out, I have everything together. No excuses having to go look for an envelope. So the instructor for this one had all the layers cut out for you. And really the only thing we had to do was some fussy cutting of that one piece of paper that I was telling you about. And then just basically glue them down. So here's an example of fussy cutting out a portion of the cardstock. Now this was an 8x8 piece of paper, and I just trimmed out a section of it to add to this card. This piece here was on that same piece of paper. So while you're not going to easily be able to see how this connects, you can see that it is a multi-layered, you know, collage kind of cardstock. So it's tricky. So, and even here where the frame is, I cut out along the frame, but you can see the flowers and stuff would have extended beyond that. And I think you just have to make a decision, or at least that's what I learned. You just have to make a decision of what you want to keep and ignore the rest. Some of these cards are 5x7, and some of them are the regular invitation size or A2 size, which is 4 1/4 by 5 1/2. And so that is everything that I made this past weekend. It was a lot of fun. I, you know, had hoped to meet some fellow crafters, but you know, that's the way it works with the way the situation is right now. I am signing up for next year, so who knows? We'll see what happens. If you are interested in this event, there's a couple of things you need to know. One is that it is opened up to current attendees first, so they get first option to sign up. Should there be any spots available, then that goes to people on a waiting list. So if you are not, or if you're not on the list, I highly encourage yourself, if you're interested, to sign up on the waiting list. So last year I had heard about this, heard that it was literally going to be taking place 5 minutes from my house. And I was like, okay, I got to sign up for this. And it's packed. Like, there are, what did I say, like 6 classes? Is that right? 5 to 6 classes for the price. Now, it's not inexpensive, but then none of these events really are. But if you break it down per class, it's pretty reasonable. Anyway, so I just put myself on the waiting list, I don't know, sometime last year. And then in May or June, I heard from Ginger, who is the person who coordinates this or puts this event on, letting me know that, you know, a slot was available. And I had actually completely forgot all about it. So I was very pleasantly surprised that I was able to get on to the event. So that is it, my friends. I hope you found this interesting. Maybe a few of these items are inspiring to you. And if nothing else, I encourage you to try something different. That's what this event was all about for me, was getting outside my comfort zone, graphic 45, some home decor pieces. And it was good. It was good to get my brain thinking in a different way. Thanks so much. And until next time, happy crafting.